The Kennedy Class III arch is described as having a unilateral edentulous area bound by teeth anteriorly and posteriorly. It is most commonly seen with modification areas on the contralateral side. The partial denture may employ quadrant or tripod vertical support, depending on the presence and location of modification spaces. Guiding planes are prepared on proximal tooth surfaces of teeth adjacent to edentulous areas. Interproximal and lingual guiding planes are obtained on the opposite dentulous side. Guiding planes are long and provide a predictable path of placement as well as frictional retention. Rests are located adjacent to the edentulous space. Rests on the opposite dentulous side are placed as symmetrical as possible in conjunction to the rests on the edentulous side. The location of these rests is governed by maximizing support with geometric quadrant design, consideration of occlusion, and consideration of aesthetics. The two most commonly used major connectors in the mandible are the lingual bar and the lingual plate. The bar requires approximately 8 millimeters between the free gingival margin and the elevated floor of the mouth. The lingual plate is useful if anterior tooth loss is to be anticipated and may be interrupted for aesthetics. The lingual plate may be employed in the presence of lingual tori by running the plate superior to the torus. The maxillary major connector selection depends on maxillary arch form, tooth configuration, and the need for support. Several variations of the palatal strap are illustrated. The U-shaped major connector is considered the least rigid of these connectors, but is very frequently used. The connector should terminate anterior to the vibrating line. A bead line is used to ensure intimate contact with the soft tissue, maintain an atmospheric seal, and help reduce food impaction. The all-tooth supported partial denture does not have a fulcrum line and does not require indirect retention, provided that the posterior abutments are clasped and have rests. Clasping is based on location of the undercut, convenience, aesthetics, or operator preference. Mechanical action of the clasp is of secondary importance, unlike in the tooth tissue supported partial. Several options are illustrated. Wrought wire may be used, but cast clasp fabricated as part of the framework may be employed in most situations. Reciprocal elements such as plating, circumferential clasps, or vertical bars may be used. The simplest design is frequently the best, and if the partial is all tooth supported, extra bracing is not required. Metal bases are used in short, well-healed segments where relining is not anticipated. Metal bases are easier to clean and may support the use of cast metal pontics. Acrylic resin bases utilizing a ladder or meshwork for acrylic resin retention may be indicated for long tooth mound edentulous areas when the loss of posterior abutment tooth is likely or when the need for a future reline is anticipated. Frequently, the posterior abutment is tipped and rotated or has an otherwise unfavorable prognosis. Ideally, the tooth is orthodontically relocated. There are several alternatives. The abutment may be used in the normal manner, if tipping is not severe, with the extended occlusal rest seat. The abutment may use clasps, which only provide bracing, or the tooth may only support a rest with no clasps. In the event that one or more terminal posterior abutments could be lost, the partial denture is designed similarly to the Kennedy Class I arch or the Kennedy Class II Modification I arch. This could extend the serviceability of the partial.